I'm Crystal Conn, and I'm a postdoc here at UCSF in the Ruggero Lab, where we study protein translational regulation and how it affects cancer initiation and progression. For us, we study protein translational regulation, so we'll change different signaling pathways, and we'll try to understand how a change can specifically lead to a signaling event that would eventually affect cancer. I have no background in science, and my mom at first was kind of against me going into science, specifically pre-med. She was like, you don't have any background, and I was like, I'll figure it out. In high school, I was more interested in art. I did a lot of photography and drawings, and then I realized I kind of wanted something that was going to challenge me and keep me challenged, like as a career. So I ended up going pre-med to undergrad. In undergrad, I ended up switching from pre-med to biochemical biology, because I really wanted a challenge, and that was when I compared like transcripts. That was the hardest major that my university had. So I ended up going for that, and that's kind of where I got really interested in research. So I thought even with that major, I'd end up going medical school, but then I started doing like some physics research as a freshman. Physics was not my strong suit, but I got really interested in just the problem of coming up with a hypothesis and trying to like figure out how to solve a puzzle. Day-to-day involves a lot of cloning, a lot of Westerns, a lot of cell culture, making presentations, a lot of reading and trying to validate like that what we're doing flows with the literature. So we'll work with cell culture. I'll be doing different drug treatments to cells and trying to see if the cells can handle the drug, if it causes cell death in like transformed models where cells are more cancerogenic. And then we'll try to see if we can move this into a more in vivo system. Day to day can sometimes feel a little bit like tedious to some degree, depending on what you're doing. There's a lot of times you do something and it's like almost perfect, but you need it to be a little bit more clear because you want to validate that what you're doing is accurate and that you're getting a good representative of what's actually happening. You do some reading, you get a few ideas, and then you do a few quick preliminary studies in the lab, like, you know, I'll take cells, I'll add a drug, I'll look to see if the result is what I assumed it might be, or if it's something else, and then I might have to adjust my hypothesis based on what I see. And then thinking about where I can take that long term to solve a bigger question, something that nobody has seen before. And I always get really excited, like, it might be hard if I have to, like, get up at 8 a.m. to do, like, a 18-hour day or something like that. But then other days, it's like, I want to jump out of bed because, like, I get really excited to be like, okay, what's the result going to be? The overall goal of knowing that it could affect, like, clinical treatments and cancers is really exciting. And it's not just one type of cancer that this could affect. It could affect, like, at least three that models that we're looking at. So that's the bigger interest for me, is that we're studying very complicated systems, but they're relative to multiple areas. For working in a cancer lab, it's exciting because you know you're helping more people. So, like, I wanted to go pre-med, and then I realized if I went pre-med, I'd be working with patients, and I realized I probably couldn't handle that emotionally. I thought it would be too upsetting for me. But knowing that I could help them, you know, with the basic molecular research, I thought was really interesting, and it would have maybe a bigger impact to more people. I really liked thinking about how things worked, and I thought that research was better for me, so that's why I went to grad school instead of med school. But for me, I've been touched by cancer a little bit. My father's had skin cancer multiple times. I think there's obviously everyone's been affected by cancer, but I don't know if that's what drives me to do the research I do, but knowing that the research I do could affect more people is exciting. What I like about biomedical research is that I can actually take basic molecular biology and not just assume it might help some person eventually. Like, if I can actually test something in vivo and see a physiological effect, then there's more of a chance that it'll help a person in the long run. And I think that's what I enjoy most about it.